Hey people, Paul Muckle here. Today's what date? Today's July 9th, 2012. As you can see, I have on my GPS monitor. It's charging up. People, as you can see, they tag me like I'm an endangered species or I'm some kind of wild animal that when it get too close to a certain zone, they can know where he's at. See that? See what they did to me, people? What these people done to me? Anyway, I'm walking on pins and needles because I'm scared this thing gonna fall off any minute, you know? It's like rubber with hard plastic. And I'm bony, so every time it hit my bone, that thing could, you know? I don't know, I'm just nervous wearing it. But anyway, this is so stressful, okay? I'm laughing because it's so stressful. This thing is putting so much stress on me that, yeah, I might have to seek some medical attention when I'm done with this thing, yo. I'm laughing, but it's not funny, you know? Today, July 5th, 2012, Paul Muckle here. I got out of lockup on July 3rd. But I was unable to enter my house because they had changed the locks. But this is how my house looked. This window was left open. The bank never secured the house because I left the window open before I got locked up. And look at my house. My TV is gone. My computer monitor is gone. They destroyed my house. This is what they did to my house. Everything's on the floor. My house has been ransacked. Look at this. They have ransacked my house. This is the third floor, the attic. They tore up my steps. Tore up the floorboard. Wow. This is what the government has done to me, okay? This is what Wells Fargo Bank has done to me, okay? Wells Fargo Bank has done this to me. They have lied on me, okay? This is what they have done to me. All for what? So they could take my home from me, okay? So they could take my home from me. This is what they did to me, people. Just so they could take my home from me. That's justice for you in America. This is American justice. American justice. Wow.
May 2007, the market for mortgages, the interest rate should have been 6.50%, and my $4,000 income, they realized that I could afford to pay my mortgage and still afford to meet all my other obligations, between my other mortgage, everything, with $4,000, if they was to give me the correct interest rate and the correct payment. And the investor said no. The investor is a foreign investment bank. They ordered an American company, Wells Fargo, to take me to court, to take me into an American court, that an American judge may throw me out into the street like I'm a dog, me and my kids out into the street for a home which, come on, I work for this. I mean, I work for the fees that I paid, I work for that. You know, I paid only $12,000 in cash out of my pocket, I work for that. I didn't steal it, I work for that. You know, I mean, and the mortgage that I paid, I work for that. I put over 30 grand in maybe up to 50 in labor and material to upgrade the property. I worked for that. You know, no one gave that to me. I worked for that. So, and you trying to take that from me? I mean, is that right? I mean, these foreign investment firms, is that right? But our government have allowed. Okay, our government have allowed this to happen to me. Us. And when I said our government, I mean the former government have allowed this, and the new administration need to stop it in its tracks. I mean, don't it was all a part of it, Mr. President. The bailout was a part of the plan. They knew they were going to be bailed out. That's why they wasn't scared to take a risk. They had so many safety nets. They had the insurance, and they had the taxpayers, and they had Bush. Okay. They had those assurances. They knew that there would be safety nets. And all you're doing is enabling them, sir. Nip it in the bud now. 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 I mean, sir, this is my philosophy. If you're in a boat and that boat springs a leak, okay, you could bail the water out that boat for the rest of your life until pigs grow wings. That boat don't continue to sink until you plug the leak. If you're an alcoholic and you cut down and you're drinking and your consumption, it doesn't matter. You're still an alcoholic. So, my point being, let's nip it in the bud.
I know not what course others may take, but as for me, give me liberty! Oh, give me death!
Oh my God!